last video, we looked at the pathogenesis. We had started with the pathogenesis of alcoholic liver disease. We have seen that we have seen the first 5 points. There are totally 10 points. So let us revise the first 5 points. Direct hepatotoxicity by ethanol. Ethanol will go and damage the microtubules, mitochondria, membranes of hepatocytes. Just remember what is there in the liver? Hepatocyte. Those things will get damaged. Then you have hepatotoxicity by ethanol metabolites. So the ethanol metabolites are also very, very, very toxic. They will also cause hepatotoxicity. Now acetaldehyde produces hepatotoxicity by forming two adducts. What are those two adducts? Protein aldehyde adduct and malon dialdehyde acetaldehyde, MA adduct. So this protein aldehyde adduct will cause hepatic necrosis, hepatocellular necrosis, and this MA adduct will cause some kind of fibrogenesis. Fibrogenesis will be caused. Oxidative stress, because of the oxidase enzyme, so easy. Because of these oxidase enzymes which are going to oxidize the ethanol, lot of oxidative free radicals are formed which are going to create oxidative damage on the hepatocellular membranes, proteins, etc. Then you have immunological mechanism. Ethanol will directly have immunologic effect on hepatocytes. It will also suppress the cell mediated immunity. Then again you have Mallory's alcoholic hyaline. I don't know why this Mallory. Have you seen the word Mallory so many times? Look at this. Malon dialdehyde acetaldehyde. Mallory's alcoholic hyaline. Now moving on to the fifth point that we saw. Inflammation. So intestine also gets injured and pro-inflammatory substances are released. That is the tumor necrosis factor alpha, interleukin 1, interleukin 6, tumor transforming growth factor beta. And all these cause the apoptosis and necrosis of the hepatocytes and an inflammatory reaction in the liver. Now we are going afresh. The sixth point, fibrogenesis. So what happens is the stellate cells, they get activated and this causes fibrogenesis. Okay. What are these stellate cells? Do you know what stellate cells are? These stellate cells are nothing but the lipocytes or fat storing cells. Okay. Earlier they were called as lipocytes, but now they are called as hepatic stellate cells. They have lot of other names, by the way, okay? Like they are called as perisinusoidal cells and they are in the liver. They were earlier called as lipocytes or fat storing cells. These cells, what they do once they are activated, they facilitate fibrogenesis by damaging hepatocytes. And because of these malon dialdehyde acetaldehyde adduct, by activating Kupffer cells, these are the macrophages, right? And also direct stimulation by acetaldehyde, all these will promote fibrogenesis. All forms of collagen are increased and hence they transform the fat storing cells into fibroblasts and fibrocytes. So what happens here? Fat storing cells get converted into myofibroblasts and fibrocytes. Is this clear? So who and all are working here for this to happen? I'll tell you who and all are working for this to happen. The Kupffer cells, these people are like the Kupffer family, macrophages. They come and they damage everything here. Malon, this is a MA adduct. MA adduct also comes and destroys everything here. Acetaldehyde itself is a direct stimulant. Hepatocytes which are damaged. All of these are going to promote fibrogenesis of the liver. So liver becomes fibrous, then it becomes cirrhosed. Let's move on. Increased redox ratio. What happens? There's an increase in the NADH by NAD ratio and this leads to lactic acidosis. Is this clear in any way? No. Anyways, I'll try to explain to you as much as what we have understood. The NADH by NAD redox ratio will increase. So the, remember this diagram, right? In this you had seen as the alcohol is getting oxidized, NAD is getting reduced to NADH. Now NADH is the reduced form and NADH is increasing in quantity. So the NADH by NAD ratio is increasing. Okay, this will lead to some lactate pyruvate metabolism, which will lead to lactic acidosis. Correct? What was it? Lactic acidosis. So let's put a red here. It leads to lactic acidosis. So this redox potential, which is altered, will cause fatty liver, collagen formation, gout, gluconeogenesis, and altered steroid metabolism. Okay. I'm not breaking our head much about it. Let's move on. Retention of liver cell water and proteins. Alcohol is inhibitory to secretion of newly synthesized proteins by the liver. So it will not allow the proteins which are synthesized by the liver to leave. So all these will get accumulated in the liver, in the hepatocytes. So water is continuously retained in these hepatocytes, and even protein, it will lead to swelling of hepatocytes and hepatomegaly. Okay, hepatocytes are unable to release the water and proteins. They swell. Hepatomegaly. Finally, the liver itself will enlarge. Hepatomegaly. Okay. Do you remember the three steps which we have seen in alcoholic liver disease? Steatosis. Steatosis, that is fatty liver, hepatitis, fibrosis, cirrhosis. Actually, I'm just adding a fibrosis step here. Okay. Let's move on. So now let us see what happens. The next thing that happens is hypoxia. Now hypoxia, chronic ingestion of alcohol increases oxygen demand by liver. So there's an increased oxygen demand by the liver. Result in hypoxic state, which causes hepatocellular necrosis because of this hypoxia in the centrilobular zone 3. So centrilobular is the center, this is the inside part, that is zone 3. Okay, here what happens is the oxygen can't reach here. It needs more oxygen, and oxygen cannot penetrate this far, or oxygen is really less. It is not able to get enough oxygen. So there is centrilobular necrosis. Last point here, increased liver fat. Why have they put it here? Fat increase there only, right? Fat, because of chronic alcoholism, rise in the amount of fat available to the liver. The amount of fat available to the liver itself increases from exogenous dietary sources, excess mobilization from adipose tissue. So lipid accumulation in hepatocytes. Fat, excess amount of fat is available to the liver. Excess mobilization from adipose tissue. Increased lipid synthesis by the liver itself. Okay, all these will lead to lipid accumulation in hepatocytes, causing fatty liver. Guys, we finished all the 10 points. So I think we will take a very, very quick revision. Instead of revision, let's do one thing. Let's try to recall. That's better. What do you say? Ready for recall? Very, very good. Tell me, guys, what and all you have learned so far in this liver. Tell me. Direct. First of all, what have we studied? Alcoholic liver disease, pathogenesis, direct hepatotoxicity by ethanol, then hepatotoxicity by ethanol metabolites, in that you had acetaldehyde. Under acetaldehyde, you had two adducts. You had the protein aldehyde adduct. This will cause what? Cytoskeleton loss and some necrosis. Then you had the MA adduct. MA adduct is what? Malon dialdehyde acetaldehyde adduct, correct? Adduct. And this one caused what? What did this one cause? I don't remember. Found it. It causes fibrogenesis only, nothing special. It causes fibrogenesis due to PAR-gamma receptors on hepatocytes. Let me put it here. It causes what? Fibrogenesis due to PAR-gamma gamma, correct? No, PAR, PAR, gamma receptor on hepatocytes. Very good. Then what was the third point? Oxidative stress, STRESS. Very good. Oxidative stress because of meow enzymes. They will oxidize the ethanol. They will release free radicals which will go and damage everything. Then we had immunological mechanism. There we saw what? Ethanol can directly do immune attack on hepatocytes. It can also, there can be direct immune attack. And also it can suppress cell mediated immunity. Fine. Then you had inflammation. Under inflammation, what did we see, guys? Do you remember anything? Yes. Come on. Inflammation. Intestine is injured. So now you have pro-inflammatory substances like interleukin 1, interleukin 6, transforming growth factor beta, tumor necrosis factor alpha. Am I right? Shall we check again? Hold on. That's absolutely right. Then these will cause the apoptosis, necrosis of hepatocytes. Also, it will cause the inflammatory reaction in the liver. Then we got the, now let us look at the other remaining 5 points. Redox ratio will increase. NADH will be more than NAD. So there will be lactic acidosis. Okay. And this lactic acidosis, what will happen because of lactic acidosis? Again, fatty liver, collagen formation, etc. Then you have hypoxia, especially zone 3 will have centrilobular hypoxia, zone 3 will have, okay. Then because the oxygen demand of the liver has gone high, then you have the things that are retained in the liver, like liver hepatocytes are retaining. Are you able to see, guys? Hepatocytes are retaining water and protein, and also it's becoming a fatty liver because the fat is getting from all the parts of the body, it's getting deposited in the liver. The liver is not able to process them. What else? Increased liver fat. Okay. So again, this is what is happening. Retention of all water, protein and fat will cause what? Hepatomegaly. Last, we are coming to fibrogenesis. So now what happened? Because of activation of stellate cells, because of these damaged hepatocytes, maadduct, acetaldehyde and Kupffer cells, the stellate cells are activated. Stellate cells are nothing but the lipocytes, right? And fibrogenesis happens. Finally, the cirrhosis happens. Is this clear? I hope it has become easy for you and you will write at least something in the exam. Okay? All the best. Tata. Bye-bye.